degrees, but it's still very cold, so I'm wearing my stupid hat. I buy this in Nepal. And I'm wearing my sweater I buy in the Peru. So I look like a fool, but at least you stay a little bit warm. So here we are again, same route for the third time. But today I take a little different route within the city because we have to cross the whole city. So on one side is the ocean road. You can follow the footpath and the cycling path. It's quite nice, but it takes extra time. Then on the other side is the main road. It goes through the city. There's a lot of traffic lights. It's a little bit more busy. Right now it's Sunday morning, so it's still okay. But this road is in between. This is like the industrial road. So there's a lot of factories and cargo stuff. A little bit ahead there's a market, but I guess that's closed on Sunday. So this road is very, very quiet. So that's perfect. If you take the ocean road, at the end you have to climb up and you cross the main road. So if you take the main road, it saves you a little bit of climbing. So I take this in-between road, and a little bit further I go to the main road. And then it saves me a bit of climbing, maybe 10 minutes or so, but still, it's something. And we already seen it anyway. But, I mean, obvious the coast road is way more nice, but I walked there already one day up and down, and then I ride it up and down, so I've seen it now. So today is nothing new, it's exactly the same route. We ride up, we ride down, and we ride up again now. So there's no reason too much to film either. So I try to go straight from here to Lans, and from Lans to camping. Then we go further tomorrow. Because we don't have to see the same things again over and over. Over and over again. I have to fix my mount, because with every bump it's falling forwards. Already said that about a month ago, but I still didn't do it, but it looks like it's finished now. But they don't sell any of those stuff here, at least I didn't see it, so I cannot really replace it. So what I will do is I try to scratch the plastic with some scratching paper. Maybe it get more grip, but I'm not sure that's gonna work either. But yeah, anyway, let's continue riding and I see you at the launch spot and after that at the camping. And for you this will be a quick day, for me it will be extremely long because it's exactly the same. Especially the climbing, but it is what it is. Okay, see ya. So as I said, straight into Lans. Before at the industrial area I buy myself a sandwich and I buy two bottles of drinks. They only had this. This is some sort of strawberry taste, this I have no clue, it doesn't say it, but they had this, so I buy this. So that's something. And then I buy a sandwich. They charged me 3,000 for the sandwich. That's probably the cheapest sandwich I ever had. Not only that, it's also the biggest I ever had. Not even sure how to show you. This is the sandwich. It's crazy, eh? I had... Shit. I want to save the plastic bag. Check it out. This is the sandwich, eh? Look at my hand. Look at the size. Very good, eh? are you just gonna eat it? Intersection to Taltal. So today we did 60. Last time we did 160. So we did 240 kilometers just to arrive here. Beautiful, beautiful. The wind is as strong as ever. So as soon as we hit the side road, I think it's almost impossible to ride. But we have to figure it out, because right now I cannot really figure out where the wind is coming from. Sometimes it's the left, sometimes it's the right. And I keep flying from the left to the right. It's almost you're on the dance floor, but not very easy riding. Well, we take the side road here. Well, the wind. Well, the wind. Sandstorms, they're some sort of tornado twister thing, whatever you call them. Kind of cool, but not if you have to cross them. But we will see, we will see. So the wind is quite brutal, it's the same story every day. A guy just stopped, gave me some water, some melon. That's really nice, but the wind is breaking me up right now. It's absolute crazy. I'm riding in the lowest gear and I'm almost not moving, but I try to keep it go a little bit further, and we see how far we can go today. This is mental, eh? closer to the mountain, so maybe I'll go there. But if you're closer to the mountain, there's maybe less wind, because the wind will come over the mountain, maybe. Sometimes for a split second the wind is gone, and it comes back straight away.
Does look the same, eh? Doesn't look really bad. There's lentils, there's rice, there's meat. Looks quite good. I'm too tired to heat it up. The winter's gone, but I'm too tired to unpack my stuff. So yeah, I kinda just eat it cold, but it looks quite good. This is a good find. I buy another one. There's some sort of minestrone soup something in it. I don't remember exactly the price, but I think this is around 5 euros. Anyway, it's quite great. I only have two. It's quite heavy. That's the downside of it. Okay, let's taste it. I'm not sure this is gonna work when I film it. I'm not gonna film that I eat it, because otherwise my mom's gonna... No, she's not. I was kidding about that, eh? My mom don't care. She only said I cannot eat and talk at the same time. It's not bad, but the lentils taste a bit like beans from a can. So they're a bit, how do you call it? But the taste is quite good. I need some salt, and I will add some spices myself, because I like a little bit spicy. But yeah, you put a pinch of salt in it, and it's actually quite good. Cold is nice as well, I must say that already. So yeah, without further ado, let's find the salt and let's eat it, because it's already getting dark. I don't know, it's still there, but it was the orange sky, or red sky. Very nice. So the whole ground clears up. So yeah, let's have food, and I see you tomorrow morning. One last climb. Hoppa, let's go. Good morning, YouTubers. Welcome to the desert, where my ass is freezing. When I woke up, it was 10 degrees in my tent inside, so outside it was even colder, probably around 4 or 5. So I stay warm during the night, that's not a problem, but now coming out, it's getting already a little bit warmer. It's now 12 degrees, but it's still very cold, so I'm wearing my stupid hat. I buy this in Nepal. And I'm wearing my sweater I buy in the Peru. So I look like a fool, but at least I stay a little bit warm. Yeah, I have some bread, I have some coffee. And the sun is still behind the hill, so I think maybe 15 minutes that will come. It's running late as well, I mean sunwise. It is now... what is it? It's 8 o'clock. I don't know what's happening here. Yeah, it's 8 o'clock. And the sun is still not out. So, yeah. Between those hills, it stays cold for a little while. Also, my tent gets a little bit too wet, but it's drying in the wind already.
So they say it's a very dry desert, but still at night things get quite wet. You can see last night was very cold, because to boil the water for the coffee, that took forever. And there's still wind going on as well. That's not very very usual, that's keep going during the night and the morning, but there's still quite a lot of wind. Not a lot of wind, but still some wind. Yeah, without further ado, let's have breakfast, pack everything, because if you can see, it's a big mess. And let's hit the road, and yeah, let's see how far we can go today.
Good morning!
So we're climbing. We already did 100 meters, and we have to do another 650 or so. Then we reach about 2154 meters. I think then we do something like 200 down, 200 up, 200 down, 200 up, 200 down, 200 up. And then we go 2154 meters down. So that's in 40 kilometers, I think, something like 5% downhill. So that should be quick. Absolutely beautiful here, eh? Very quiet on the road as well. Down, up, down, up, down. It keeps going and going. The climbing is quite tough. It's really warm and there's quite strong wind. What's not in our favorite. So we did 80 kilometers so far. It's about 35 more to go, but the rest of it is all downhill. You already see up front that white is all the clouds, so you can really see we go down a lot. And we go towards the ocean, that's why there's clouds. I'm not gonna go all the way today, because I don't want to sleep in the city. I just want to sleep in the desert. And then tomorrow we roll into the city and we buy some extra water and we continue, because there's nothing to do in the city, but there's a few restaurants and I can buy water there, so that's great. It's now let me see, it's 6:15. Before the wind was crazy right here, it's still strong, but it's okay. So I think I might start searching for a camp spot, because I don't want to be into the clouds. It's very beautiful, hey, the clouds up front. Into the hills. Over the hills and far away. We're gonna do camping here. Not the best spot, because the road is right there. I can see the cars can see me, but I'm way too tired and this environment is way too harsh. So I'm just gonna clear out the floor a bit and call it today. I'll make some soup, some chorizo, something to drink. I built a wall for shade. make myself some seat here. If you can see, the road is right there. It's very quiet, but if you can see on that side, it's 1 hour and then the sun goes down. So I just have my foot and I start clearing out the ground and put up a tent. But I'm extremely exhausted, so I need to drink and to eat something first. And later I will set up my camp. So I prepare my camp spot. If you can see, the sun goes down already. So there's still a little bit sun. There's the road. You see the traffic is coming, goes around the corner right there. Here I prepare my camp spot. So if you can see, it's very soft sand. So when you look this, you think you cannot camp here. But when you start doing this, you see you have a very smooth ground. You see? So it's a few minutes work, but even in this rocky terrain you can do camping. So therefore you can do camping in every situation, in every, not in every situation, but you can do camping on every different grounds, but you need to understand the ground. So first you check and then you choose your spot. So you can see, when the sun goes down you get less contrast, so it is very hard to see because my tent is pretty much the same color as the mountains, a little bit more light. But we're now about 10 meters away, if you can see, the road is still 30-40 meters. So if you look very far away, it's very hard to see my tent. And you must understand, people don't expect me to be here. So that makes difference, right? Because they don't look in this direction. I gonna try to film this, but it's probably too dark. So what I gonna try to do is light myself, well, not light myself, but light the tent a little bit. If it doesn't work, I will put this text over over another footage. So then you know the reason why it's maybe... I don't know, this is working. What I want to say is also the reason why I waited with putting my camp, first of all, there's less contrast when the sun goes down, but that's not the main reason, because we're quite close anyway, so they will see it. There's another reason I did it. Normally I don't bother too much, because I always try to find a spot nobody sees me. And so far it always works, but today it didn't, so people see me. So I don't know where I'm camping, because I don't know where I am. So if people came up to me and asked me, what you doing here? And imagine it's 4 o'clock and say, oh, I cannot make it to the city, I have to camp here because it's getting dark. That's bullshit, because you still have 4 or 5 hours of daylight. So when the sun goes under and you set up your tent and people will come, and you explain you cannot make it to the city and you have to camp and tomorrow morning you will leave, they, at least they will understand it. And I'm 100% sure that's not a problem then. So yeah, that is also a reason why I waited till the sun goes down, because... Good morning, internet. So you see a white pole, white pole, white pole, and next to that white pole you can see there's a tent, but you have to look very closely. Then there's this two white poles, one white pole, and then a little bit to the side, that's where I did camping. And we follow the road already, we climb up here. Now we're on the road, this is the direction we came. And this is the direction we're going. So let's ride. The first 20 kilometers is downhill. Now we have to buy some water and drinks and things. And then it's another 55 kilometers flat next to the ocean. Then I think a hotel or a campsite. I saw a campsite, so we'll check that out. And then after that we go back into the desert again for 150 kilometers. So we did about 10 kilometers downhill, and I have to wear already my arms. that is different sleeves. It's really cold going down here because the wind is so strong. Very beautiful here. We already crossed the sign with Animal Crossing as well. Look at that, you can see the ocean. To the hotel. Pretty straightforward day. I had a shower, did some washing, did some repacking, charging some stuff, watching some river monsters on TV, nothing too crazy. Had some dinner here, buy some new bread, so we all set to go tomorrow. And then it's another 2 days before we reach another village. Right here there's no phone reception, nor there is Wi-Fi. So maybe in the next place, maybe not. I don't care. Yeah, so far we'll call it a day. If you like this video, put a thumbs up. Leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.